not available now. Please leave your name and phone number after the beep. We will return your call.
Sanka, you dead?
Yeah, man.
Went to Africa a week ago.
Where'd that go?
Kill that lion, then I kill that goat.
Kill that goat.
Yes, I'm a human being, but when did you recognize that? Was it after they wrote in the American Constitution that I am only 3/5 of a human being? Was it while I was a slave? Was it while you were exploiting my people in Africa?
Many, many moons ago, in the lands of Tasmania, a group of hunter-gatherers lived in harmony alongside nature. These people were in total isolation from the outside world, free to roam around as they pleased. What happened to them that resulted in the complete extinction of their race? This is their story, the Tasmanian people.
Foreign Concept, the unapologetically black podcast. The Tasmanian people lived on an island just off the coast of Australia. They are said to be the descendants of the first humans to migrate out of Africa. A rising sea level separated them from their Australian cousins, leaving them in total isolation. They managed to survive on their own for thousands of years, developing their own technology and tribal structures until the Europeans arrived. The Tasmanians had three major encounters with the Europeans that turned their world upside down. The most significant involved the British Empire. Britain was at the peak of its powers globally, but chaos was happening within the country. This resulted in prisons being overpopulated. So as a diplomatic mission, the British decided to send all their criminals to a new colony.
The island would be used only for the very worst convicts. All contact with the outside world was forbidden.
The settlement of criminals was established in 1803 in Tasmania.
Thus began a holocaust of European savagery, swirling into the island, which was now a prison.
The first encounter between the British settlement and the Tasmanian was so horrific that it was described by scholars as a massacre. Podcast. For years, both the British government as well as the modern-day Australians have tried to cover up the slaughter that took place during the first initial contact between the Tasmanians and the British settlers. However, accounts of the incidents have now been uncovered.
There is an account of the man in charge that he was drunk, that he wanted to see the niggers run, as he said. That this was a sort of a show of force, and we can imagine that show of force delivered from that hill into that field.
It is imperative to remember that the ancient Tasmanians were descendants of the first humans to migrate out of Africa. Therefore, they were black. Devastating as their first encounter was, the worst was still to come. In a short period of time, the Tasmanian people faced genocide in all forms. Their food supply was being affected due to the introduction of new animals. The diseases brought into the country by Europeans was killing them at an alarming rate. By 1818, the Tasmanian population had been reduced from 20,000 to 2,000. With the population down to its bare bones, self-preservation kicked in. The Tasmanians started to fight back.
Man on man, in this guerrilla war, the Aborigines could hold their own. They used the tactics of hunting. The Europeans were always complaining that the Aborigines never sought a fair fight, as they said, never fought in the open. They always hit one or two men when they were on their own, when it was getting dark, when they weren't looking. And then as soon as they turned around, as soon as any sort of show of force was developed, the Aborigines weren't there. They were behind, they were hitting somewhere else. This was classic guerrilla warfare, and the Aborigines were brilliant at it. There were four black men killed to every European man killed. This was the best ratio ever achieved in the colonization of Australia.
The fighting, however, did more damage than it did good. For every European that died during battle, the British Empire were able to replace with someone else, whereas every death for the Tasmanian was a step closer to their extinction. The settlement, or the colonizers, depending on which point of view you look at it from, grew frustrated at the fact that the Tasmanians were fighting back. So what they did next was sickening.
The atrocities committed by sealers and convicts and reported to the 1830 committee included rape, flogging of women, burning with brands, roasting alive, emasculation of men, cutting flesh off living bodies and feeding it to dogs, dashing out the brains of children, kicking off a baby's head in front of its mother.
Britain wanted to give off the impression that the settlers and the natives were coexisting in a perfect world, where all men were treated equal. This lie resulted in 20,000 British migrants moving to Tasmania. These migrants arrived in Tasmania with the notion they were better than the natives.
There were some who even denied the Tasmanian Aborigines the status of human beings. One settler referred to them as orangutans. Another wrote a book describing them as the most debased race on the face of the globe, the connecting link between man and the monkey tribe. Some looked to the Bible. Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it. They made the point that the Aborigines, having no agriculture, had neither replenished nor subdued the earth, and therefore should be removed from it on the authority of Scripture.
These people are the forefathers of the current-day modern Australians. Once the British migrants arrived, the general in charge of the new settlement decided that the Tasmanians had to move out of the land.
In April 1828, the governor issued an ambitious proclamation ordering all Aborigines to leave the settled area.
The Tasmanians responded through the use of violence. They started attacking camps in areas in which the British took away from them. The government placed a bounty on each Tasmanian's head that was seen anywhere near a settlement. You could either shoot them, bring them in, or receive a reward. Even with a bounty placed on each of their heads and with numbers falling close to 100, the remaining Tasmanians kept on fighting.
The attacks of the Aborigines, perhaps their last great attack upon the white people in this part of the world, had crumpled back the edges of the European system. The system itself was in danger of collapse in the frontier regions.
All they had for weapons were sticks, whilst Europeans had guns. To make things worse, the general in charge called upon every able body in the settlement to take up arms and attempt to finally get rid of the Tasmanians.
A decision was made that there was only one answer to assert the European presence in this land, and that was to wipe every black man off the face of this earth.
Foreign Concept, the unapologetically black podcast. Descendants of the first human. And the Tasmanian was so horrific. Britain, fuck off, you fucking knobhead.
Drop one of DJ Clue's bombs for this episode, goddammit.